everyone, how are you today? Personally, pretty excited because Christmas is around the corner, so it's really exciting. Even though I still don't have the gift for my family, so I should rush doing shopping. But we're not here to talk about this. We're here to talk about some pretty controversial topic, or the random one, you know. You like to talk about this maybe, but you don't find anyone to talk about this with you. So, you know me, I'm here, always there, because boys, girl, I got you. So let's get started. So today's topic is gonna be body type. Yes, but I'm not here to tell you what is your body type. You can find it all over internet, on books and whatever. I mean, all I know, I think it's the common one, you know, the random, like the letters one. I think there is V.
Do you have broad shoulders? Do you have a tiny waist? Does your body get narrow and slim towards your legs? If so, you're definitely an inverted triangle.
A.
Pear. A pear-shaped body is characterized by a much larger hip measurement than bust measurement.
O.
Apple. If this is your body type, you tend to gain weight in your midsection.
H.
Rectangle. If you have narrow hips and an undefined waist, you have a rectangle body shape.
And K. I call it K, it's an hourglass shape, you know, that is very trendy these days. I call it K because like Kardashian shape.
Hourglass. While this is the most desired body shape.
That's how people call it over there, you know, in the country where, you know, those people elected someone with like blonde hair and orange face. You know who I'm talking about, right? I'm not giving names. I'm not putting myself in trouble, but you know, I know you got me.
When Trump does it, it's like really weird.
I want to congratulate the North Dakota State Bison, Canada, Nevada, Hispanic. Any Hispanic here? I think so. Any Asians? Asian, any Asian?
Donald Trump's very, very large. A brain.
Knives.
You know, the windmills. Boom, boom, boom.
So yeah, today we're gonna talk about body type. Why? Just because one of my friend, like one of the girls that I'm following on Instagram, it's Blokey Late. She's amazing. I love her. She's always giving a lot of positive advices and whatever.
Five different hacks that you can do to get your energy levels up without having to drink coffee or drink an energy drink.
She made a post where she was just showing her body Photoshop in each decade beauty of standard beauty in terms of body type. Yeah, 16th century or 17th century, you had to be like very like, you know, curvy, but like limit very overweight to be attractive. But then, you know, throughout the year, it changed. Sometimes they like a childish body and... Other time they're like a very woman, curvy or skinny body. It really changed throughout the years and it was very interesting. I love was a post that she write under it, you know, like the comment box. She said that these days people are doing things wrong, you know, they're like reversing things. Normally you should adapt the clothes to your body type, right? But no, of course not. I mean, like, people don't change. They always twist things all the time. That's like, I think that's a human thing.
You got me twisted. You must not know about me. You must not know about me.
Now what people are doing is that they are adapting their body type to clothes because they want to follow the trend, which is kind of very weird because in this generation, in our generation, I mean, like, we're well aware of all the Photoshop stuff and, like, you know, there is a lot of slogans and, like, hashtag and, like, you know, association against all this photos, the Photoshop thing and, you know, like, a woman object and this kind of stuff. And there is a lot of, you know, fights for body positivity and this kind of stuff. But we still are so many, and I'm talking about girls, but I know there is a lot of boys out there that are doing exactly the same. Boys, I see you, okay? So don't try to be like, that's a girl thing. That's a boy thing too.
Ooh, why you working like a stranger? What's with your behavior? Ooh,
there are so many people all over the world, girls and guys, they're just like going on crazy diet. They're like working out like crazy, even though they don't enjoy it. If you don't enjoy your workout, then stop it. That's not the purpose of the workout, okay? You must enjoy it, like this girl. Going down for real. I haven't worked out for a while, but anyway, they are just torturing themselves basically just to fit a pair of jeans or, you know, a size, because society said that that's how you have to look like. But people, remember something. In 2000, it was just 20 years ago, it's like next door, you know, what was the body trend? It was to be super skinny. Everybody wanted to be like that. And now, look, now it's the complete opposite. We have to be like super curvy and, you know, like show your shapes. If you're flat, people are like, ugh, blech, what is that, you know? That's stupid. We all know that trend is changing all the time. So it's so much easier to adapt a cloth to your body than to adapt your body to your clothes. And it's not even healthy to do that, okay? It's not healthy psychologically and physically. Okay, so I don't know why people are just doing this, especially in certain countries, like, you know, the one that I talked before. Make America great again. Being your boss's friends, we're always happy to greet ya. They'd slap your ass and say, nice to meet ya. You take it with a smile without any bitch, and then you head on home to your place in the kitchen. Your husband rarely hit ya, and that was ace. Blacks, Jews, and Mexicans knew their place. Back when girls were girls and men were men. Oh, let's make America great again. But also, I'm thinking about a few like Eastern Asian countries, like South Korea or China. I think it's the countries where like plastic surgery is such like a common thing. I mean, I swear, in South Korea, plastic surgery is a gift that you get for your graduation. So your parents are offering plastic surgery when you graduate. It's insane. I think in our world, in the Western world, that sounds so insane. Maybe not in America, but at least in Europe, you know, where we all try to be natural and, you know, all this shit. I'm so fucking sick and tired of the Photoshop. Show me something natural like Afro with your bra. Show me something natural like ass with some stretch marks. So much common sense, but for us it's like, wow, she said something new. But this girl is, she says in the future, she's not here. But we all know that, okay? The thing is that we get that body positivity things going on, but to be real, it's a lot of fake things happening there, you know? Not all positivity movements are right, because they're just telling you, and that's so stupid, you know? They're just telling you, you know what? You have to accept your body, you have to be so confident, you have to like yourself. Basically, what they really want to say is that you have to like your curves, but in the right shape. I think for me there's a lot of hypocrisy behind that. Not all movements are like this, but a lot of them are like this. You know, you cannot say just accept your curve when you're showing to everyone exactly the same type of shape of body shape. That's not working. That's not all the curve that is in the world, okay? So yeah, I think there is a, I don't know if it's a misunderstanding, it's a communication, because maybe it's just like our human female or male, like, you know, a characteristic. We always want to have an example, something to follow. So we just got to choose something that looks nice, like symmetrical. Even when talking about shape, you know, like you have like the boom, wow, boom. And about that wow, you know, the waistline. Let's be clear. Let's take a moment to talk about this.
Oh. No.
Oh my god!
Your waist is so small!
I know!
Do
too far. What the hell did I do to myself?
It's not normal to have a waist that is like that. I mean, like, where is your fucking stomach? You have to get your stomach out of your body if you want to get a waist like that. This is all Photoshop, of course. I mean, this is crazy. You can have a big body if you want to. You can have big boobs also, your plastic surgery. But to get a waist that is like this, girl, are you fucking kidding me? That's not possible. Where is your stomach? What are you eating? You're not eating. You can't, because there's a stomach there.
Places. I see the magazine working out Photoshop. We know that shit ain't real. Come on now, make it stop.
Be careful about what you're watching. Try not to follow the trend. If you do going on diet or like exercising, do it for yourself. But if you're feeling guilty each time you're not doing it, and then you cannot enjoy the moment when you're like kind of cheating, then it means like you're doing this for the wrong reasons. And I think you should sit down and take a paper and analyze yourself and think a little bit about what you want. If you want to spend your whole life based on people's opinion, or if you want to be just happy the way you are. That's very easy, that's very simple, that's a lot of common sense. I'm not saying anything new. I'm saying things that you can hear all over the internet, but still there is so many people who don't get that, and that's kind of sad to me. That's what all I wanted to say about body type. I hope I help some people or not. Maybe some people are mad or are just bored, whatever. I say what I wanted to say, and if you have some comments or you like, you know, to tell me more about this, get some advices, or tell me that what I'm saying is just shit, feel free. Really, feel free, just be respectful, that's it. And you can do it or on my Instagram page. I'm really an Instagram girl, so don't hesitate. Snapchat too. I'm slowly getting back to Snapchat, but you're gonna hear a lot of songs because I love to lip sync and sing, even though I'm not a singer, just to let you know. Or Twitter if you want. I still have it, not using it, but I still have it. So you have all those options. Apart from that, I think we're all good, and I hope you're gonna have a great week. Bye bye. Oh, and to finish, you must have noticed it. I put all the head to toes, you know, recap video that I'm doing on my Instagram. I finally post all of them on the channel, so you can watch it. It's very condensed, the quality is not amazing. It's really like all the phone videos, so you have, you know, that format. And they're just gathered together per week just to see how I'm changing style, because I just noticed today that one of the things that I really love about doing this video is just to get ready for it. I really like it, apart from like the editing part, which is really fun too when you have to find videos and whatever. But this, you know, dressing up part and showing you like my African like clothes, I really, really enjoy it. So I hope you enjoy it too, and have a lovely week. Bye bye.